Drink.
Hey guys, it's Lola
and it's Sam,
and this is Blooming to Beauty.
We know what day it is.
Friday.
Friday. Woo-hoo. Here we are with our favorite drink.
Yes, yeah. Our pomegranate margaritas. Mm. Let's have it. Let's.
Yeah. Salud.
Salud. Time to unwind and relax and talk a little bit about makeup.
Yeah, so today's video, we figured we're going to be going over our top five nude lipsticks.
Yes, as you guys know, we love makeup overall, yeah. But we love a nude lip. Just as so. Look at me. Mm-hmm. And we have different skin tones, we have different preferences, so we thought it would be fun to talk about our favorite
nude lipsticks. Yeah, and I think another good thing that we're going to be doing, because obviously we are going to insert swatches of the colors that we tell you about, well, swatched on our hand.
Right.
But we also wanted to wear the color, because sometimes colors do look different on the back of your hand rather on your lips. So we figure, so you can see both sides of the spectrum, we'll just wear them.
Of course. So now we don't know what each of us has chosen.
Yeah, no.
So that's exciting too.
Yeah,
we'll be able
random.
To find new ones if we don't have one. So I'll start with my favorite one of my.
There you go.
Sake. I didn't write this. Like, I don't have a number one favorite, and this is number five. They're all like my favorites.
Yeah.
I didn't have one specific.
Oh, I have
one.
A favorite.
You do? Oh, that's gonna be exciting. Mm-hmm. You save that one for last.
Yeah.
Okay. So the one that I'm wearing right now on my lips is from Milani, and this is number 60 Matte Innocence. Check it out. The packaging is so cute.
It is.
It's so cute.
Cute.
Just gold, sleek, right? And then you have your lipstick.
Boom.
I love it.
You know, I'm really excited because I'm looking over at both sides, and we don't have any that are the same.
Yes,
so that's good.
I love it. Yeah. So anyway, Milani, it's great. You guys already know most of their stuff in their drugstore is great. That comes from Milani, top brand for me. Very soft, like any lipstick, right? You have to apply it every 3-4 hours, but it's not a big deal to me, because either way, at the end, you know, middle of the day you have lunch anyway, so I might as well just reapply then. Okay. But it's good, it's soft, doesn't dry out my lips or anything like that, so definitely a top favorite.
Awesome. Yeah. So then for me, my first favorite, you can reapply your lipstick there.
Yeah.
Because you're gonna have to take it off with our wipes.
Yeah.
My first is by Anastasia Beverly Hills, and it is her liquid lipstick in Stripped. It is the color that I have right now on my lips.
Oh, it's a liquid lipstick?
Yes, it
nice.
Is a liquid lipstick. So I think it depends on what you like. I know some people really don't like liquid lipsticks because some do tend to dry. This one is a little more on the dry side, but it doesn't bother me. Mm. I just put like a moisturizer underneath or something, like a lip balm, and I'm fine. But if you were somebody that you didn't like liquid lipsticks, just don't look at it.
Just don't look at it.
But if you do ignore like it, this is the color Stripped. It's really beautiful. It lasts on lips. You know, liquid lipsticks are meant for that purpose, so that you can eat and drink and everything. You know, eat and drink.
Eat and drink. Let's see. Let's test it. Let's test that claim right now.
Yes. And, you know, it stays on the lips. So, you know, this is one of my favorites. I will, like I said in the beginning, we're going to insert also swatches on the back of our hands so you can get a little bit of a closer look. But this is the color. So,
it's beautiful. I really like it. And I love how it goes with.
Yeah, and I will also say that for the most part, I am a lip liner girl. I know a lot, you know, not everybody is, but I am, and I am one that usually I like applying, like, not completely brown, but like nudish brown lip liners under my nude lipsticks. That's just my preference. For this video, I'm not doing that just because I want you guys to see the true color of the lipstick without that underneath. But just putting it out there.
Yeah.
You know,
usually
when I do wear it, I wear a little bit of a brownish nude underneath.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Perfect. So this for me does classify as a lipstick. It is a lipstick, but as a nude, because it's very, very light. It's a pink you know,
like a pinky
like
nude.
A pinky nude. Mm-hmm. My lips are a little bit more on the pinky side, so for me it's kind of just like, you know, a little extra. And this would be one of the NYX butter lipsticks. This one's on the name Cotton Candy. Mm. Cotton Candy, very nice, again very smooth, very light. I normally would wear it with a lip gloss on top, like a very nude pink. I love that look, but again, because the purposes of this video, we just wanted to show you guys the, you know, the true color. So as you can see, it's very light. I do gravitate towards those kind of nudes, like a little bit more peachy, a little bit more pink, because of my undertones and because of my preference. I just prefer warmer, you know, warmer lips, warmer eyes, warmer everything. I know Sam prefers more of a brown,
yeah,
and she'll talk about that in a few minutes, but yeah, I just love it. I think the butter lipsticks from NYX are another great drugstore alternative, like most of the ones that I will talk about. But they're just, I just love a good nude. I just love a good nude.
Who doesn't? Mm-hmm. Okay, so I have number two here. Yay. Have it on the lips.
Oh, it's so pretty.
Isn't it pretty? Mm. Honestly, I've never even heard of this brand until I saw Carly Bible here on YouTube, and she like was doing a video, and I was like, what is that color on her lips? And so she spoke about this color, and I thought it was so pretty, so obviously I am wearing it on my lips right now. I just applied this bad boy. It's by the brand Mellow.
Never heard of that.
So I don't know, I just plugged it in to, you know, my good friend Google, and
that's right.
I had purchased it on Amazon. It wasn't expensive. It's more of a
mid-range,
a
cheaper, maybe?
Yeah. But it is in the color Posh. And it is a matte lipstick. But I really enjoy the color. I think it's really, really beautiful. Go ahead.
I mean, it's
I like
very
the packaging.
Cute. Look at the
yeah.
packaging. It's cute. It
I
reminds
mean,
me of
a MAC.
Right?
Yeah, a MAC with them. They're related.
They are cousins. Maybe they are cousins.
You don't know.
No, it's beautiful. What a beautiful color.
Yeah.
It's very nice. Yeah, very so, you, Sam. Mm-hmm, and it's very chic. You know, the mm-hmm. the packaging, I love it.
Yeah, the color, the nudish, it has the gold embellishments. You know, I really, really enjoy that. And it's really, really pretty. But I just put this on with like a brown, like I said, brown lip liner. I mean, I just love it. And I do, I am that girl. I mean, I'm not over here going for like outrageous lips, but when I do line my lips, I do like to overline my lips a little bit, and it's not anything drastic. It's like literally just like over, like very slightly. But when I do that in like brown and I go over it with a nude, I just think it looks so beautiful, and I can't get enough of it. I don't know. Can any of you guys relate with me? Just let me know. Just let me know, because I really do enjoy it. So
love it.
Oh, I see that nude on your lip.
Yes, you do.
Tell us
so
about it.
So this one is from ColourPop. And I really like their lipsticks. This is a glossy one. So I like all about the shine. You guys know that. Anything that glows, anything that's shiny, that's what I gravitate towards. This is a Skimpy. I really don't know if it's still available.
Yeah.
So I'm so sorry if I am mentioning something that's not available. This is the only thing I'm not sure that is out of my favorites. I think everything else is pretty pretty permanent in collections. Mm-hmm. But anyway, so this is a Skimpy. Mm-hmm. And I really, really like it. It does remind me a little bit of the Milani one that I was talking mm-hmm. about, but the Milani one is the matte, whereas this is glossy. Like, I don't even need to apply anything else. This is lighter, you know, lighter than anything else, but I do like that look. You know, again, makeup is about preference. So I know some people don't like the whole like concealer look type of thing, but I think it looks great. I think it looks good. And you know, you can just mix it up with any eye color. That's the beauty about the nudes, that you can just have anything in your eyes and just pop up a nude lip and you're done. You're set to go. So I really like this one. A Skimpy, they do have a Skimpy also as a lip liner. And this is the lip liner of my choice. So I always use a Skimpy, the lip liner, also under all of my nudes. That's my favorite one to use. I really don't gravitate towards anything else. I always use the same one.
Okay, so my favorite is by MAC, and it is in Honey Love, which I'm wearing right now on my lips. This is actually my mom's, I think, favorite nude. She's gone through so many of these.
Wow,
but
that's nice.
She loves it. But yeah, I think it's a beautiful nude. Like Lore had just mentioned, you know, nudes are just so versatile because you can wear them with any look, really. And there's so many different undertones when it comes to nudes. There's peachy nudes and brown nudes and pinky nudes. And, you know, so like you can really tie in any nude with an eye look and it's going to look amazing. And honestly, 99.5% of the time, that's what I end up doing. Even if I say I'm gonna go with a color,
yeah,
then I end up going with a nude because I just love the way it looks. But yeah, this is MAC Honey Love, and I really, really, really like it. It's so beautiful.
I love it. The other one that I absolutely love on my end is from Rimmel. And this is part of the Kate Moss collection.
Yeah.
And this is 41. Let me see the name of it. What does it say? Ta-da-da-da-da. No, it does not have a name. Rosetto? Yes. In color Rosetto, number 41. I think it goes one more by number because the number is like,
yeah,
really prominent there. Anyway, this is another one that's a nude, but it's more of a pinky nude. It is a little bit more toned down, I feel, or like, you know, nude, as compared to the one from NYX. The NYX, I feel like it's a little more bright. This one's a little more like everyday nude, just that pink undertone. I love it. Once again, good formula. It's not matte. It's just a very regular satin lipstick. So it doesn't have the high shine like the ColourPop Skimpy did, because that one was an actual glossy. You could see it in my lips, like it was really shiny, like if you had a lip gloss on top. This one, very normal, satin. Again, the number 41, a pink. I love it. It's one of my favorites. Definitely one of my everyday shades that I wear every day. And it's cute. And the packaging
is
also cute,
it is
really right?
Cute.
It's like very nude with silver. It's cute. I really like it. So go get some.
Really beautiful. So I've realized that all of my lipsticks are matte.
They're all matte,
but that's okay. So the next one I have here on my lips is Bow and Arrow by Kat Von D.
Ooh.
This is one of her Everlasting liquid lipsticks, and let me tell you, when this shade came out,
yeah,
it was not easy to get. Like, it sold out so fast.
Yeah.
And then like when it would like restock, like I guess like so many people wanted to get it, like sometimes it would be glitchy and stuff like that. But when I was finally able to get my hands on this, I mean, I think it's so beautiful. I believe Lode had mentioned it earlier because, you know, I'm more into brownie nudes, and this is definitely more of a brownie nude for me. But I love this color, and, you know, right now it is still a little wet, but it does dry down completely matte. And it is more comfortable than, like, the Anastasia one.
True.
If you were to, like, ask as far as comfort, which one's better. But I think it's just really beautiful. I mean, look at this nude. It's so gorgeous. And, you know, I don't even know what to say. I get so excited.
So
I'm like, it's so beautiful.
Just look at it.
Bow and Arrow, Kat Von D. So gorgeous.
I love it.
Yeah? Well, here it is.
Nice.
Yeah.
Beautiful. So my last favorite, it is one of my newer favorites. I got it like maybe 2 months ago or something like this. Because I never seen this brand. I don't know if it's a new brand. Don't quote me on
Where
it.
Where do you get it?
I got it at the drugstore, oh, right at Walgreens. CYO. I don't know if you've heard of that one. Me neither. Never heard of it. I saw the display. I picked up a few things. And this is a standout for me out of the stuff that I picked out. It's supposed to be a plumping lip gloss. So it does have that, you know, minty feel to your lips. I don't really know if it plumps. To be honest with you,
yeah,
that, I don't know.
I agree. I
but,
feel like a lot of the time,
yeah,
it's just
no. Nah. But I love how it looks. It's that milky pink peach look to your lips. It is a lip gloss, so of course you have to reapply and reapply and reapply throughout the day. But I would always prefer a lip gloss, even over a lipstick. As much as I love lipstick, I will always prefer a lip gloss. It's just easier. Just throw it in there. Go move on. I don't even wear a lip liner if I don't have the time. So for my everyday looks, a good lip gloss would do. And this is a nude. goes with everything. Call it a day.
Did you say the color? I was kind of
reminded. No, you're correct. I don't think I said it. All psyched. This is all psyched. It's like that milky look. It's very nice.
It
love
is it. Very nice. Mm-hmm. Final nude and my favorite nude. Oh. So it is definitely more on the brown nude side. Mm-hmm. But this is just like, I feel like this is the lipstick that I always carry with me. Like I'm always constantly changing lipsticks and I have like a bunch of like, my bag like kind of explodes after a while with so many different lipsticks in it. But this is the one, no matter what, I always keep it with me.
Yeah.
It is also by MAC Cosmetics and it is in the color of Velvet Teddy.
Nice.
I just love this. This has always been my go-to since the moment I tried it on, I fell in love. And this is just, you know, it's really hard sometimes to say you have a favorite. There's just so many, but this is my favorite.
That's
like,
it.
This is the one I always carry with me. And I really, really love it. I think it's beautiful. And it is matte. But, I mean, you know, I feel like if you put something, like I've been, I mean, you guys clearly have seen, but I've been applying the Makeup Forever HD Lip Booster just as a moisturizer beforehand because I'm over here, the first color, and this is how you can really tell, like the Kat Von D one came off really easily with the wipey.
Yeah.
The Anastasia one?
Oof.
I was battling a little bit. Like, for that, I need oil to, like, take it off.
Yeah.
And then I'm like, I don't know how some people do, like, lip swatches. Like, that's I know crazy. Anastasia Beverly Hill recently came out with more colors. So, mm-hmm. I'm sure there are people that do, like, the whole collection lip swatches. And I'm like, my lips would be on fire. Mm-hmm. But, yeah, so if you put something like that, like a balm underneath, then it doesn't look completely matte. And, you know, these are regular matte lipsticks. So, obviously, they do transfer. Everything like that, but it's just really, really beautiful. Velvet Teddy by MAC. Those are our five.
You have 10 options here, guys. And we gave you a little bit of everything, high-end and drugstore. So you have options. You can go. We'll start swatches as we speak. I know you guys saw it in our lips, but we'll also swatch them in our hands and start swatches like we always do. And I hope you enjoyed it.
Yeah.
Tell us what is your favorite nude?
Yeah.
Should we check out? We love nudes.
We do love nudes. You can never get enough.
Never.
They're all so different.
They're so different.
Definitely. So different. But so definitely enjoy the rest of your weekend. Enjoy. I thought it was your favorite.
Oh my god.
You're just dropping it.
I don't care. No way.
But enjoy the rest of your Friday, the rest of your weekend. And rock a nude.
That's right. That's what you should do this weekend. And we'll see.
Don't rock yourself nude.
No, don't.
Just rock.
Yes, the nude lip.
You never know.
And after a drink.
Yeah.
We don't know what they're thinking. So have a good weekend, guys. See you guys next week. Bye.